Hello friends, Kalrao School Halol presenting this video for standard 9th English medium subject SS. Friends, today we are going to discuss about chapter number 10, part number 4. In our previous 3 video, we already discussed about the previous part of this lesson, though. So those students who hadn't seen that videos, firstly go and watch that video so that you will get the idea about the lesson. Now in this part number 4, we will conclude our lesson with the last video, the chief minister and the council of the minister. Okay, the chief minister is the head of the minister, and uski jo cabinet minister hote hai, council of the ministers are there. The chief minister is appointed by the government. Who appointed the chief minister? Governor. The governor appoints the leader of the majority party as the chief minister. Okay, the leader who was the who was from the majority party, who become the chief minister. If no single party gets the majority, if in the election not a single party get the majority, the leader of the combination of the parties, okay, jisko hum kehte hai jo jode mein sarkar banti hai, that is called combination of the party, gathbandhan, okay, that consisting the majority or the leader of the largest party having the support of the majority is appointed as the chief minister. So this is the process to make the chief minister. In the condition where no one with get the majority, in that condition both the party get the merge and they will decide who become the chief minister. Other member of the council of minister are also appointed by the governor on the advice of the chief minister. On the advice of the chief minister, other members are also appointed as a council of minister. Through the administration of the state is carried out in the name of the governor. In reality, the chief minister and the council of ministers enjoy most of the power of the governor. Okay, chief minister and council of minister are enjoy their power of the governor. In Gujarat, the office of the chief minister and cabinet minister is situated into the new secretariat, Swarnim Sankul, which is situated at Gandhinagar. The governor administrative of oath of secretary to chief minister and the council of minister orally, and then after they sign the same. Okay, this is the process when they become the or they get the post. In the state cabinet ministry, there are 4 type of minister. If you are talk about the cabinet ministry, there are 4 type of the minister. Number 1, a cabinet minister. Number 2, state level, deputy level, and parliamentary secretary. Okay, so this 4 are the ministry type. Okay, the chief minister distribute the protocolic to the cabinet minister. The chief minister is the person who distribute about the protocolic to the cabinet minister. He also presented the issue of the policy making the transport administration questions of the people of the central government. During the time, the claimly the he provide the basic amenities, love and care to the people. So this is his duty. He provides in a strong leadership to the state. Okay, he provides a strong leadership to the his particular state legislative. The chief minister is the torch bearer and pathfinder. Okay, so wherever the state will go, it is depend on the decision of the chief minister only. So he is the very important person for the state. Okay, of the government policies regulating the growth of the state, it is depend on the chief minister only. Now next point is about the administrative system. Okay, administrative system means administrative executive. The political executive frame various policies in a different field. If you are talk about the different field, the political executive frames a various kind of the policies in the different kind of the field. The detail and the efficient implementation of these policies is done by the administrative executive. Whatever the detail and efficient implemented implementation was there. It is done by the policies and done by the administrative executives. The administrative executives advise and guided the state executive. The administrative executive, what is his duty? The administrative executive advise and guides the state executive in its matter of policies. It provide required information and figure. They provide the required information and figures. However, the political executive is not bound to follow the advice of it. Okay, very simple. No matter how important or welfare oriented the policies law, if they are not efficiency implemented by the administrative executive, then its purpose is marred. Thus, the administrative system provides the necessary backup to the executive into the formulations and implementation of the policy. So this is the basic thing for them. Expert and professionally efficient and the experienced public servant in the field of the foreign relations, defense, security forces, international trade and commerce, nuclear energy production, distribution, banking, insurance, foreign exchanges are the backbone of the government. In the exam, the question will ask in one mark, which are the backbone of the government? You have to write the list of all. They all are the backbone of the government. Very easy. Collector is appointed. So listen it very carefully. Collector is appointed as an administrative head at the district level. Okay, at the district level, collector is appointed as the administrative head, and his office is into the Jilla Seva Sadan. Barabar hai, Jilla Panchayat. Expert is knowledge, administrative insight, board exercise, prediction, administrative efficiency helps them to carry the administrative effectively. So all that our department are there to help the collector run a smooth administrative for the particular district. From the organs of the government, the state executive acts as a brain behind the welfare of the people. Whereas the administrative executive is like the limb, the amicable relation between the political executive and the administrative executive is prerequisite for the smooth governance of the state. So administrative is only when happen at the time when all worked together with coordination. In power and influence of the government is becoming more central into the bureaucracy. Nepotism, corruption, dishonesty, inefficiency, misconduct, escapism are the evil of the bureaucracy. Okay, so to control such kind of the evil, Lokpad and Lok Yukti is needed. To nowadays it is normally to meet the corruption into the government. So this is very common thing for all the government administrative offices. So for that they appointed the Lokpad or Lok Yukti. To stop the corruption, Gujarat state government has started an entire separate department. Okay, Corruption Bureau. I hope you hear this name, Anti-Corruption Bureau. Gujarat government has established to stop the corruption. Here given it's a toll-free number 1-800-233-4444. People can contact the number to file their complaint. If you want to do the complaint against the corruption, you can contact this helpline number. Political stability is expected from the administrative system, as there is a government comprising of the different political parties. The administrative system helped to axel the development of the government by implementing the various development scheme and program. So government has implementing the various development scheme and program for the welfare of the people. Okay, now next point. Governance at the local level. Okay, which governance are work at the local level? If you are talk about the local level, taluka panchayat, jilla panchayat, gram panchayat, that is called local level, local self-government. It is extremely different to carry out the governance at the entire nation from a single place, as the central government has way too many responsibility. If government was sitting on a single place and it work for an entire nation, it could be a difficult for him to serve to the people, and their responsibility were becoming very huge. The power is discretized with the objective to timely solve the various problems, need, expectations and aspirations of the people. By decentralizing the power, the administrative can be carried out easily and efficiently. By distributing the power, by distributing the work, the administrative work can become very easy and efficiently. At the local level, if you are talk about the institute of the local self-governors have emerged. If you are talk about the local self-government, the local self-governance, it has emerged when the administration of the village, okay, if you are talk about the administration of the village, town or a city, is carried out by the representative of the people elected by the local and the local institution, then such a organization are called the institute of the local self-government. The government which is worked at the local level, at the town level, at the village level, that is called local self-government. Okay. For administrative efficiency, the geographical regions, the responsibility and the functions of the government are divided to the local organizations. Similarly, the municipality, municipal corporation are, and the institutes of the local self-governments of the urban area, and for the villages, one can find the gram panchayat, taluka panchayat and district panchayat. So this is called local self-government. Those who are working at the local village level, local level, town level, city level, so that is called local self-government. Institutions of the local self-government given in a training. Okay, whatever the institutions are there of the local self-government, for given the training which is available for the election, voting duties, responsibility, administration and ruling. For opposing the parties and opposing the parties, all that types of the training which is available for them. It gives the opportunity to local self-government, as all the policies are implemented at the local level first. It gives a chance to improve the license at the upper level too. Therefore, local self-rule organizations are known as the training school. See, this is very important. The local self-rule organization are known as the training school and laboratory of the constitutional improvement into the democracy. If you are talk about the year 1992, in entire country similar Panchayati Raj, an urban institution of the local self-government came into existence. Into the year of 1992, if you are talk about into the entire country, Panchayati Raj and urban institutions are local self-government came, okay, in reality. Three-tier structure of the Panchayati Raj. Three-tier structure of the Panchayati Raj. So, number one, institutions of the local self-governance at the ruler level. Okay, ruler means gaon. Gaon mein jo institutions hoti hai for the local self-governance is that ग्राम पंचायत, तालुका पंचायत एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट पंचायत इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव स्ट्रक्चर. वेरी इजी. एट द लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट इफ यू आर टॉक अबाउट दिस थ्री, ओके, विच देस दिस थ्री, ग्राम पंचायत, तालुका पंचायत एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट पंचायत इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव स्ट्रक्चर. ईच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज म्यूचुअली ज्वाइंट फ्रॉम द टॉप टू बॉटम. एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज म्यूचुअली ज्वाइंट. From Gram Panchayat is joined with the Taluka, Taluka is joined with the district from top to bottom. At all the levels of the Panchayati Raj, in order that local development task, for that task is that local development. बराबर वहाँ के area का development करना, that is its task. Scheme and welfare oriented programs are carried out efficiently. These organizations are provided with the required fund and means. This organization need what? Required fund and means. This is the chief of the district panchayat and the various chairman and the various committee of the district panchayat wears the administrative head of the district development officer. Okay, DDO. This is the full form, district development officer. Chilla Vikas Adhikari, district development officer, that is called the head of the administrative at the district level, and the main office of district panchayat situated district headquarter ke office jo hai wo district ke head. In Panchmahal if you are talk about, to Godhra ke andar district office hoti hai. Similarly, the leader of the elected wings of the taluka panchayat is called the president of the head of the administrative wings, that is called TDO, Taluka Development Officer, Taluka Vikas Adhikari. At the lower level, Sarpanch, if you are talk about the Gram Panchayat, Sarpanch is the representative elected by the people at the local level, Gaon ke level pe. And the administrative head of the Talati Kam Mantri, aur uska administrative head kon hota hai? Talati hota hai. And the hands of the administrative of the Panchayat. The village in which the election and the Sarpanch are unanimously elected are declared the Samras village and not honored by the, and it is honored by a prize. Okay, here given the Indian constitution, you can see the chart. Second organ of the government, you can executive. Okay, it is divided into two types, number one and number two. Here number one, central level, state level. And number three is about, C is about institutions of the local self-government. Okay, here governor, chief minister, and here legislative assembly, okay, secretariat. So here if you are talk about the rural level and urban level, so political executive and administrative. Political executive ke andar kya kya hota hai? Rural level pe panchayati raj is working there, president, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट, डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पे, ओके, जिसको कहा जाता है डिस्ट्रिक्ट डेवलपमेंट ऑफिसर, डीडीओ. इफ़ यू आर टॉक अबाउट द तालुका पंचायत, तो तालुका का प्रेसिडेंट और वाइस प्रेसिडेंट मेंबर होते हैं. टीडीओ जिसको कहा जाता है इसके हेड को, इट इज हेड इज कॉल्ड टीडीओ, तालुका डेवलपमेंट ऑफिसर. एंड इफ़ यू आर टॉक अबाउट द ग्राम पंचायत, तो डेप्यूटी सरपंच एंड सरपंच बोथ आर वर्किंग फॉर दैट, और उसका एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव हेड होता है तलाटी, ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड ग्राम पंचायत. सो दिस चार्ट यू हैव टू ड्रॉन in your notebook, that is compulsory that you have to draw this chart. I will see whenever I will check your notebook whether you are drawing this chart in your book or not. So this is the administrative structure of our local self-government, and it is very important to you to draw this one in your notebook, okay. Now next point, Urban Institute of Self-Government. As per the 74th constitutional amendment into the urban areas were provided with a urban institute of the self-governance as per the population of the area. At first level there are a municipality, at the second level municipal corporation. Listen it very carefully, we are talking about the urban institute, okay. If you are talk about the 74 constitutional amendment in the urban area, if you are talk about it, it provided by the urban institute self-governance as per the population, okay. Population jis hisab se hoti hai, according to that urban institute was distributed their work only. At the first level municipality, second level municipal corporation, and third level महानगर पालिका निगम. ओके दिस थर्ड आर देयर इन द थ्री विंग्स ऑफ द अर्बन इंस्टीट्यूट सेल्फ गवर्नमेंस. अ मेयर इज इलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द मेजोरिटी विंग. मेयर इज इलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द मेजोरिटी विंग. अपार्ट फ्रॉम देयर ओके अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस देयर आर द चेयरमैन ऑफ द वेरियस कमिटी एंड कॉर्पोरेट्स. ओके सी इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द अर्बन इंस्टीट्यूट गवर्नेंस ओके तो चेयरमैन होते हैं कमिटी के कॉर्पोरेटर्स होते हैं एज पर द वेरियस वार्ड. वर्ड वार्ड वाइज अलग अलग वो कैबिन कॉर्पोरेट होते हैं. दे आर वर्किंग फॉर देयर पर्टिकुलर वार्ड. इट मीन्स देयर इज अ वन टाउन और वन सिटी. इट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू डिफरेंट वार्ड. वार्ड नंबर वन वार्ड नंबर टू वार्ड नंबर थ्री वार्ड नंबर फोर. सो वन पर्सन इज वर्किंग फॉर द वार्ड नंबर वन. दिस पर्सन इज वर्किंग फॉर दिस वार्ड. दिस पर्सन इज वर्किंग फॉर दिस वार्ड. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ द रिजर्वेशन फॉर दिस टाइप ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन वर्क डन बाय देम. और वुमन के लिए अलग रिजर्व सीट रखी जाती है. कास्ट की अलग सीट रखी जाती है. वेरियस कम्युनिटी कैरीड आउट द वेरियस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ द कम्युनिटी इन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ द कॉम्युनियल एरिया दे आर वर्किंग. दे आर टेकिंग द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू डेवलप देयर पर्टिक्युलर ओन कमिटी ओके ऑफ द मैनी फील्ड इन टू द डिस्कैंशियल मैनर. सिटी प्लानिंग लैंड इनफॉर्म रोड ब्रिज फ्लाईओवर ब्रिज कंस्ट्रक्शन वाटर मैनेजमेंट स्वेज मैनेजमेंट सिविल डेवलपमेंट एनवायरमेंटल फैसिलिटी फायर डेवलपमेंट सर्विस एजुकेशन हेल्थ कल्चर एंटरटेनमेंट सिटीस्केप डेवलपमेंट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द मोर क्रेमिनेशंस ऑफ द ग्रेवयार्ड रिमूवल ऑफ द स्लम. All over development etc. was done by the Urban Institute of Local Self-Government and it is done by the properly ward member. Okay, all are managed by its field collected from people under the public-private partnership that is called PPP, the full form of the PPP, public-private partnership. As well as the taxes collected from the people. Okay, the taxes which are collected by the government from us and government grant. The administrative head of the municipal corporation is known as the municipal commissions. Under him, there are a zonal head having the technical and administrative knowledge and various officers. When a cordial relation is established between elected wings and the administrative wings, then main works can be carried out relating to the welfare of the people. So this is entire process is described about the Urban Institute and self-government. Now last point is about the judiciary. The Constitution of India has accepted the ideas that all the citizens should get a social, economical and political justice, thereby just and equitable social order can be established. If any person break any law, then he is either punished or fined by the judiciary. If any person is broke the law related with the constitution, he or she will punished by the judiciary. The judiciary check whether the laws are accordance with the constitutional provision, and if it laws is not consistent with the Constitution, it declared the law unconstitutional and void. If federal system power and function are divided among, if you are talk about the federal system and power and functions are divided among the union state and the centers, it is the functions of the judicial system to see that the both the central and the state government carried out their own work without interfering with each other work. Okay, this is the rule for everyone. Which any dispute arises between the central and the union state, if there any kind of the dispute were arising between the central and the union state, then they are solved the Supreme Court. It will be solved into the Supreme Court only. The Indian judiciary is if you are talk about the Indian judiciary, it is the continuous and linear. All the top of the central level, there is a Supreme Court. If you are talk about the top, there is a Supreme Court. At the middle, that we know, High Court is there, and the bottom, that is a local level court. That's the trial court, civil court, criminal court, and various subordinate court. So this is the pillar about the judiciary. So this is the organ of the government. Last is about the judiciary. The finally, the lesson number 10 is completed here. The lesson we completed in 4 part. This is the part number 4 we completed today. This exercise number 1, 6 question answers till 10th question answer. Exercise number 2, 10 question answers. Number 3, 7 question answers. And number 4, MCQs are there, which are 10. Okay, so all these MCQs and question answer you must have to write down in your notebook. I will check your notebook only, and related to this video, whatever the question answers are there, that I will send you through the PDF. And this chapter's test will be organized tomorrow. Tomorrow I will send you the test paper in your school application. So you must give the test. Okay, 20 marks test with organized for this chapter. So you must appear the test. The marks will be given to you. Okay, in our next video, we will discuss about new chapter, new topic. Okay, friends, bye. Take care.